So my name is Donna Wilcock, and right now we are in the Sanders Brown Center on Aging at the University of Kentucky. This is an Alzheimer's disease center designated by the NIH. We also study other diseases of aging, such as stroke and cardiovascular disease. My research focus is on Alzheimer's disease and the comorbidity of Alzheimer's disease and cerebrovascular disease, looking at the vascular contributions to cognitive impairment and dementia. I'm from England originally, and I did my bachelor's degree in Cardiff in Wales, and my degree is in pharmacology. While I was there, I did some research experience in a lab studying epilepsy and realized that I was really interested in the brain and everything to do with the brain. And after that, I did a short postdoc in New York at the Albert Einstein College of Medicine. And then I did a much longer postdoc at Duke University before getting the faculty position here almost 5 years ago. My dad was actually a coal miner, and he had an accident mining and retired early. Actually, growing up, I wanted to be a vet. I wanted to be a veterinarian. And so I worked in a vet's, and that was gonna be my career path. And it just so happened that when I did my A-levels, which is kind of the last thing you do in England before you go to university, I didn't get the grades to go to vet school. And so I decided that I would do pharmacology with the option that I could probably go to vet school after that first degree. But then during pharmacology, I kind of caught the science bug and the research bug, and that was it for me. So my role has really transitioned now to directing the research as opposed to doing the research. And so I think my folks actually get a little scared if I try and pick something up in the lab now. I enjoy, and this is going to sound really strange, but I do enjoy writing the grants and the papers and really directing where the lab is going to go in the next 5 or 10 years. A lot of times my students will come to me and ask me to look at their slides with them. So we'll go on the microscope, and together we'll look at the slides. We'll go through what the pathologies look like and what it means, and how they might be able to quantify it. And if it doesn't look good, we do some troubleshooting and outline some steps that they can take in the lab to make it look better or clean it up. And then you know, I'll go into my office and I'll start working on a grant or working on a paper, and that'll happen till the next meeting comes up. I think the first step is get into a lab, you know, volunteer some time to a research lab that's doing research that you're interested in. You know, we'll have websites now. So find someone, if you have a family history of a disease that you want to learn more about, find someone in a lab that's studying it. And I bet there is somebody at your university doing that. A lot of high schools now are affiliated with local universities. So we have a partnership with a local high school, and we get students coming in doing research, even in their high school years. And then once you've done that, you know, just enjoy it. Don't feel like you're only doing it for a certain amount of time. Just enjoy doing it. And I think, you know, if you have the bug, then you have the bug.